Okay, if you're going to tune in, I'll say it now, thanks very much. So I'm just quickly filling with the TV. My opponent had a few levels to take. Two normals and a move up. So I've just bought another player just to give myself a bit more of a bench, because I've got a feeling that we're going to get some removals in this game. I'm going to suffer some, but we'll see. So, 150. Do I take the wizard? Somewhat tempted to take Skitter. Can actually afford Glart too. Take the wizard, save the bank for the next game. This is a very important game. A win here would mean big things for the team. Yeah, all right, go for the wizard. Couldn't afford the claw unless I use all my bank, so yeah, as tempting as Skitter and Stab is, I think that may have been a good one. It would only cost me 10k from the bank. That may have been a good one, but it's somebody that can be hit, can be blitzed easily on a three dice. And with these extra two block pieces, you know, I'd be relying on tail shadowing, which is effective. But he could just very easily knock me down or remove me. Yeah, we'll see. Shenanigans. Yeah. Gonna risk it. I'm gonna go defense. He gets LOS hits first off, but he is lacking Mighty Blow. Not that that is a huge thing, but okay. What do we get? Okay, so I got the Fane. Let's give it a whirl. Where are the block pieces? So, putting an early block here with block to make it safe. Clear out this guy that would allow for a three die with the crocs, and then he's got two options. Oh, okay. Okay, so two safe blocks across, three die with the crocs, and then he's got a blitz option with that last block Saurus, so could be painful, could be good. Oof. Well, that's very lucky for me. That is exceptionally lucky for me. Did not see that happening. Okay, so you can get two hits here. He's got blocks, so he's got a 55% chance to knock me down. So that's a good first hit into a stun. Same again. Okay, I get to dodge that one, so that's good. That one's one for him, one for me. Okay, he's up against the troll. Doesn't follow, so does he even blitz this turn? Does he even blitz? Am I gonna get a reroll off him? No. Okay. Okay, so I've got a decent opportunity to get away from the Saurus, but I don't have the room, so I don't want to overcommit, because there's a 3 plus pickup and a 3 plus handoff away from running right down the sidelines on either side. If I'd had a stun on either of them, that would have made it a little bit easier. I mean, this guy here is one square further forward than this guy, so perhaps the blitz is this side. If I had taken Skitter, I would have been right up. Okay, so we burnt the one, which is a good thing, because it's going to be this side now, because I'm not doing a GFI. He's got sidestep, so he's going backwards. I'll follow. No arm break. Okay. Thank you. Okay, going to stand by the troll. So basically committed 90% of my team there. He's stunned. He stands in front of the troll and they hit him. I think I'm going to have to drop back. Let's go right back. Let's make it a GFI if he wants to come and hit him. Otherwise, it's just an easy two die without. At least I'm making another one. Burn the one, rather do it there than on the pickup. Big guys don't want to play today. My thought is being able to get everybody in a pretty straight line, pretty evenly spaced across, gives me a decent frontage. I mean, he could very, very easily blitz into the middle here and create a gap. And then a cage option would be the right side for him of my players. I mean, if he fails the pickup, I'm forcing the team reroll at the very least, which at this stage is quite good. So we're seeing potential cage being set up here. So blitz back, create a gap, come back for the cage. And then run through. Okay, so I get to dodge away. Does he come back? Yes, okay. So I'm thinking that. Okay, so he's banking on the pickup being successful, so he can come through. That's what the play is. If this is unsuccessful, or he fails anything, then I've got an option to crowd the ball. Like a 1-in-9 here, really. Okay, I would have preferred the 1-in-9 on the pickup. But that has certainly given me an option. have to re-roll this if it fails. Okay, so I didn't get... didn't get the mighty blow. My turn for 1 in 9. Okay, so not too bad. At least I've got majority of my players back the correct side of the ball for the defense. Got a player deep still, so that's useful. I have given up a block, two blocks here. Well, I do have block from this guy and I do have dodge on that guy, so but you can make that three dice very easily to chase that power that he'd need. He doesn't have block. He's got a very easy option to go down the flank. So he's going big, he's going straight to the killer. So he's got a blitz. Onto my killer. That's unfortunate. It's a good reroll. At least I've got a reroll off him. Couldn't get it on the pickup. Got it there. No armor break, so that's a very good trade-off for me. A reroll for knockdown. So I can see him blitzing my line wrap. That's what I can see happening. The reason I can see that happening is because that would free up big space here if he gets a knockdown. If he does that, he's going in against Blodge. So he's got more chance of knocking down my lineman than he does my blitzer. But then again, is a more valuable piece. So dodge onto the crocs. Following that to stay based on him, or okay, so this guy moves, not much, but he's got to. Nah, he's not in range anyway, so I'm talking nonsense. Okay, so got 4 plus dodges. Been a bit too greedy with the dodge in there. So I've left, unfortunately I've left a lot of blocks, but at least I've got two blitzers. Well, one's on the floor, but at least he's not. Okay, so he's got the knockdown, his ball carrier's not tagged anymore. I think I need to focus on, well, depending on how these blocks go, my armour. I think my focus has got to be bringing more players back. Because at the minute I'm only defending with half the team, so it's very easy. I mean, these guys are going to get pushed up the pitch, so they're calling the scoring threat. These are blocked all across the front here, which would then open up a big gap over here, actually, if they're successful blocks. So, and safe block is this one up here. Block. Okay, so I'm down a rat already. Okay, that's unfortunate. Oh, and he's a dead rat too, so yeah, I have to eat that because I've got more important pieces. So unfortunately I think that this might be the turning point of the game now if I sustain any more casualties. Dodge away from that, but then if he pushes there, he can punch away and get away from the troll. So if this isn't knockdown, then maybe he was going to cage up over this side. An option to hit either one of these. I'd probably hit the troll and use block on this guy. Oh, so there's the cage being formed. This is a bone head. To be honest, I would even consider not blocking with the crocs. Chasing a pow here. Yeah, exactly. Chasing the pow there, or boneheading even, gives me an option straight on the ball. Okay, that's unfortunate. It's been very successful both times. So I've had actually, it's a pretty bad turn for me, really. Losing the troll, and also losing losing a line rat. That's actually very unfortunate. At least I've got two dice on the ball. With Mighty Blow and a pow. I'd love a removal. Excellent. Okay. We have to try out with the fire, I think. Try and get some more dice on the ball. It's a real shame my troll got KO, because actually that. Okay, so what have I left on? So I've left two die blocks on most of my pieces, to be fair. Okay, these are three die to start with. That was without blocks, so... Maybe he's used his power there, but he's freed up block to come in and he can hit my goblin. Clear one goblin away from the ball. Chain push the blitzer away as well if he wanted. He's also got this guy here that could do that with less movement. Okay, so looking for the blitz here. Gets the full power, as they say. Really unfortunate about the troll. Never mind. Okay, so 3 plus dodge, 3 plus pickup. Or blitz is used. Only has block here and here. So if we create. completely isolate that, that line map. Got two dice there with block. Gets a pow. That was the safest block to take. So now we've got a three plus pickup without any other dice we rolled. And a 3 plus dodge into a 3 plus pickup. Okay, so we went for it. Got a 2 dice again, but without block, so a 1 in 9 would be very nice here. Went the other way, chasing the pow, got it. Wonder Boy 2 is okay. So that's a lot of dodges. So we've got 2 dodges here, and a GFI. There's tackle when you need it. So we're looking at okay, we've got the ball. He's got the ball, sorry. Going wide. Okay, again, I've got oh, I'm in a very bad position. I'm really not sure. Yeah. So. I think it didn't matter. I was just taking my time there to have a look on Samba. I was either going to have a 20 something percent chance to do a 4 plus 3 plus, or the 3 plus with the GFI was 55%. But as I just proved there, I was a 1 in 9 coming, so unfortunately, nothing would have worked in that sequence. So that's a little bit unfortunate, but it was always going to happen. It was coming. So again, we come back to this basically the same position I was in before. All I've done is rebase a goblin over here, which is. Very easy to sort out. And there's a lot of two die blocks everywhere, so yeah, he's down. So essentially, without just sort of wanting to make it a pure diceism, if I need him to have a have a dice roll, much the way I have with mine. He needs to 1 in 9 something for me to get another chance, because he hasn't moved the ball yet. And fortunately, I think that is going to seal this drive right there. I'm out of position. I'm double based. I think with the troll being out in that third casualty, yeah, that's it. I might just have to think about preservation now for and hoping for the troll to come back. Don't think I'm in much of a better position, really. We might even start fouling actually with the attrition rate. So I kind of just need armor to hold. Oh dear. So I think this game is just basically about not getting hammered 3-0, I think, because I don't see myself winning this game, and I don't see a draw being very much on the cards anymore. So I think it's about minimizing the touchdown difference. That's a big one. That's going to be an happening most likely. Oh, I still got him. I still got him. He is still dead. Okay. Well, as lovely as that was, that's quite a significant piece to take off the board. It still isn't really going to do much. If I don't get this troll back when the drive ends, I mean, I'm down I'm down pretty bad, to be fair. Yes, I got lucky on that removal, didn't I? But unfortunately, I haven't. It's not really gone my way, mate. I've suffered a bit here. We've got MNG. That's the worst we've had. Because I mean, a line rat's a line rat. So I mean, I can replace him. So, but the skill thrower. My big concern is now, obviously he's got a lot of strength on the pitch, he's got a lot more pieces than I have. The ball is almost assured to go into the end zone and be a score. I'm looking at either red dice. Red dice or just rolling a lot of dice. So he's looking for a power here again because he doesn't have block. He got it last time. He gets it again this time. Doesn't get the armor break, so I'm quite happy about that. And that's the blitz used. So wizard. Okay, so fortunately, not really a lot I can do with this game now. He's got two rerolls in the bag. I would say the first turn reroll management was good, choosing not to reroll, but gonna reroll that, why not? Looking for a mighty blow removal. Stay. Got him. Yes, thank you. Oh, it's a niggle. After the apple as well. Oh, don't want a 9. Oh, come on. Just a KO this time. Okay, so a removal either way. He should pop it in the end zone now. He's got two rerolls. And he's got Bloxaurus on the pitch in range to blitz. And he can make that a 3 dice, actually. Which I think would be a better option. So I'm going to try and survive a 3 dice blitz on my Glodger. And then he'll probably just do a Mighty Blow attempt on that guy. But I'd love a 1 in 9 there. So he's definitely stacking the odds for a pow here. 3 dice, looking for a pow, it's got to be like 40-odd%. Probably got that wrong, never mind. So come on, Blodge. Blodge works. Blodge does not work. Tough. Armor 8 works. Bonehead, For 1 in 9, please. You've used the reroll. This is a risk. There's the score. I must admit, I'm half tempted to say, please take that block and 1 in 9 it, and then I will happily take a 0-0 first half after the removals I've suffered. So we're looking at it. We are hoping not to bonehead, and we are hoping not to 1 in 9. Oh. Well, I just hope we get better dice in the second half, I think. Okay. We don't really have many players left. We are playing for pride, boys. Oh, okay, so yeah, that's a pretty much a non-starter then. He'll stack the line of scrimmage with all his strength pieces, and I think I'll make an attempt at a pass to get this guy MVP ready, and if he leaves me the option, I will try and get a mighty blow blitz on somebody, but I doubt it. Okay, so I had a snake eye for my KO rolls, but I get another chance very soon, so I don't think it will be a very enjoyable match for anyone to watch if I don't get those KO rolls back. So I can only apologise for that if the dice won't let me in, so to speak. Okay, so we've had 2 ones. Oh, interesting. Just a stun. Just a stun. Ah, that's a shame. I would love to remove it there. That does. That does at least allow me to get 2 die blocks. Oh, well. No re-roll for the catch. Just a stun. Why not? I haven't got any players left anyway. That is half time. Oh no. Oh, another. Well, there we go, guys. If you think you have bad luck in Blood Bowl, take a screenshot. I snaked both my KO rolls one turn ago, and I have rolled it. That was into dub skulls as my first block, and then I've snaked them again. So I've had 6 ones in five dice rolls, sorry. That is very, very, very unfortunate. Can't cover against the blitz, so I need a removal. Yes, okay, good. Alright. We don't catch it, we get another one. Oof, I hope these ones are just getting out of the way early, because oof, this is these dice are really starting to concern me at the minute. Okay, so I've got shorthand, so I get to re-roll the 3 plus here, whereas I don't get to re-roll the dodge down here, and I got a feeling that would Skitter, let's reflect back on my choice, would Skitter have made a difference in this game? Was my taking the wizard a big mistake? Ignoring for the moment the number of casualties. So, I think I'm pretty much going to get penned in here, which was unavoidable. I mean, I had to take a chance at blitzing somebody with Mighty Blow. With these guys here, I mean, if he positions them well, then I'm just basically not able to dodge out at all. So, triple pushes. Puts him in against the croc, so I'm on a 4 plus to dodge away on everybody. Okay, I'm not sure what the odds are, but it's a 2 plus here. Good. Got him. Go, little goblin. Whoops. Do I dare to do it again? Do I need to do it again? He has got an easy... Ah, let's leave it. Because when they trip over, they die. Okay, so he's going for the dub skulls. I get a reroll off him. I'll take that. I will take that. That is the same as a removal to me right now. And he doesn't break my armor, so. So what are we looking at? Covering the scoring threat. Probably take the block here. Dive this guy in just to really mash up the number of bases you can get, perhaps. Get some mighty blow pow on low calorie troll snack. That's not going to end well. It ends better than I thought. It ends much better than I thought. Okay, the pows keep coming. And I am, yeah, very much in trouble. Oh, yes, get some of that. Oh, dear. There's nowhere I can go to be safe, really. We are playing for pride now, boys. We are playing to cripple this team. Not gonna lie about it. If I'm gonna take a Kaz dice in, then I'm taking my opponent down with me. That is the underworld way, I think. So, oops, there's it. Let's go have a look. Right. So I've got MNG thrower. I have a busted armor line rat. Gobbos are doing well. They are literally just being lazy and taking a break. Gets the knockdown. Probably going to get the pickup as well. Scatter's actually quite good for me because... I'd love him to fail this. I'm going to tag some players up probably. Before committing to that, perhaps. So I've actually done an awful lot of damage to this team, to be fair. So I haven't gone down. Without that fight, which I'm gonna say I'm pretty proud of. Okay, so he's got the ball back. stunty. He's going to pass that. No, GFI and handoff. I get a reroll. Yes. Reroll. And we could fail this. Be lovely. We don't. Okay, so both down or a pow, please. I'm gonna reroll that. That's a lot of greed, but oh well. Oh well, let's try it. For this point, I've got nothing to lose. Okay. A bonehead would help me out, so feel free, crops. So as I was saying, I've done some damage. Strength bust there. Armor bust there. That was the bonehead. That was the bonehead. I needed that. A niggle on that guy. Oof, that's not pretty at all. He's okay. He is strength bust. Just a push. Do I dare to hope that Blodge can do a thing? Do I dare to hope? He's got one reroll. I would take that. But you'll probably reroll it. And it'd be skulls. I would like it to be skulls. No, okay. Okay, so he could dodge out, yeah, and then he could block. He could block it, stop me from scoring. Okay, so there's a possibility here. There is a possibility that I can equalize here, but that's very early to equalise, but then again, I don't have the players for a stall. Okay, so a 3 plus dodge, 2 die blitz with block, a push would do. So I need a 3 plus 3 plus to be able to score. So... Okay, I scored. I've equalised. I want my KOs back, please, Knuckle. Help me out. I will bring the troll back and I'll feed you a goblin to him. Okay, so he's got his guy back. Is that a sign of things to come? No, it isn't. Okay, so this is very much a hoping sort of situation, I think. As in, I hope that with only one reroll left, he fails a pickup or we get a little bit of luck, I think, because I don't really know how I can defend. With six pieces left, I mean, if I had those two back, eight pieces, I'd be a lot happier, especially with him only having two skins, even though one's a movement up. I've got the wizard, but I've got two skinks, so can't really cover much of the field. I need to have something in depth. I need to have a backup. My most mobile guy seems like the sensible option. We can cover both sides of the pitch. Not that I'm expecting him to race away, not when he's got four turns, sorry. Kickoff event. Both teams lose a turn. That would put more pressure on. Definitely not a touchback, which it looks like it's going to be. Oh, that was close. Okay, so still has to roll for the pickup. And he's marked everyone, so that's forcing him very early on. Although, okay, so he's got block here, actually. So he's got one safe block that he can take, which frees up the crocs. So, got a 3 die with blocks, 55% chance to get a knockdown there. Gets it. Good thing he's got block. Oh, it was the crocs! Oh! It was the crocs. I did not realise that. I actually didn't realise that was the crocs. If only I had just one more piece, I wouldn't have to So, what am I thinking? I've got 2 rerolls, 3 turns. So this is the one die. Got it. Stay. Okay, just a stun. Which then allows me to be able to drop back. Stop this guy coming around getting easy to die. So he can stand up. He's got options on the ball, but I'm making him roll dice. He took a re-roll to do that, but I think I'm happy with that. Don't think I could have done a lot else. I'm literally playing with 5 pieces, so. Okay, so the Crocs is back in, which does two pieces tagged out. When he stands up, that's that piece tagged out. It's coming round. That's a GFI with his last reroll, which he's not happy about. But if he brings this guy in here, he can blitz out with his blockless Saurus. Just gets a push. He follows. I've got 2 dice back. I didn't think he would. So. So he's got 1 piece left in. Well, I've got an idea. Okay. All right, we're gonna try it. We'll try it. You. It's got to hope, isn't it? Okay, so I gambled the wizard there. A stun would have been better on this guy because, I mean, he doesn't. I mean, he's got an easy. He's got an easy way to blitz that ball. I mean, hit my line wrap. Even just a push. And then he can. He can dodge out, tag him up. Okay, actually, that'd only be a one. Nah, he can still do it. So, I mean, give an assist here, block that away, leave him there to cancel that assist out, and then he blitzes in this way towards the sideline. I still think that was the right play with the wizard rather than just vanity or vainly targeting a skink, because at the minute where he's positioned, he's not a scoring threat, and unless he runs one of these skinks down at the end of this turn, but he's blocked his path now. Just a push. Okay, what does that give me? It's a double GFI. He's got a reroll if he wants to do that blitz. Gets the knockdown there. Probably just take the block, I would have thought. And then that lets him blitz the blodger. He's chasing a pow here. Or a double GFI with block. Or an uphill red die. As I don't have any. Okay, so I've got a hope. Come on, Blodge. Don't get it. That's unfortunate. Okay. That gives him a one die. Just a push. Rerolled it. Got a push again. Against the sideline. Pins me to the sideline. Okay. Woohoo! Yes! Oh, I did not expect that. That has been a turn up for me. Come on, give me some KOs. Come on. There we go. You wait till the end of the game, boys. Tell you what, there's nothing in the halftime wrong, the end of match thank yous for you lot. Right, okay, so he's looking at a one turn option. And I can't defend. I can't defend the one turn because I don't have players. Yeah, I can't defend it because I haven't got enough players, so best of luck to him. He has no reroll. Best of luck. Just gotta hope that he doesn't get one on the kickoff. can't wait to see the number of KO rolls I've had. Pretty sure I failed. Pretty sure I failed about four. Well, they're all ones, that's for sure. But I think I rolled. Okay. Oh no, that's the worst possible result. So I've got to hope now that he fails this pickup. Because he's now got two turns. And I've used the wizard. So that is very, very unfortunate for me. This has got to be a fail. I need this to be a fail, really. I don't think I've left myself in range to hit him. But he's got to come forward. He has to. So I get to dodge. Get towards the crocs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So he's not in passing range where the ball is. So at least there's that. So, and then if he comes forward for a handoff, oof, that was almost the dice I needed there. Another mighty blow hits. I get away with it. Casual two die. Oof, it's nice getting the pows. Okay, so he's KO'd. So what are we looking at? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so we can get to the 10-yard line. He's not going to be passing from there. Run forward and put the skink behind the Saurus as a scoring threat. Okay. Right, okay, so it's game on then. It's game on. Three dice, I need this. Got it. Removal. Stun. Okay. Alright. Might as well dodge, why not? Another turn of hits in. Yeah, Mech, I'm trying. I mean, you know, at this point, I mean, I'm just hoping that no one gets injured. I mean, I've actually still got my Apo. I mean, despite all of this over here, I held on to the Apo. So, I mean, we've got a scoring threat here still. It's Lizard. I mean, you don't know. I mean, sixes happen, don't they? So, see if never say never again. Is he going to both down it? He did. KO'd himself. Okay. Well, that was pretty gripping, that game. I've taken the win. I must admit, I'm ecstatic about that. I'm really pleased to take the win there after that first half and those that amount of removals. That was and a 6 for winning. So yes, that's the best I could have hoped for. AV busted line rat got MVP. That is a shame. To lose the MVP there, but if that's the worst thing that's happened, I've got to take that. Yeah, there was a lot of SPP for him, but then again, I did a lot of damage too. So, to be fair, my armor was reasonable, I'd say. Injuries above half. Yeah. All right, I'll take that. Dodging could have been a little bit better, but then again, I was dodging through four pluses because of tail a few times. So GFIs, I didn't get punched for GFIs. So, but I had Mighty Blow, so that might help explain the armor. Yeah. 50-50 on his GFIs. But I did roll 29 ones and 40 twos, so on a team that relies on a 3 plus dodge, that says a lot. Didn't really make many blocks, had to re-roll a few there. It's like 20 pows, but he had stunty. And there he goes. And he's got 40 on me to my 20, so yeah. Good game. Tough game. Very brutal for him on the casualties. Okay. So we are down TV because I've got an M&G thrower. Yeah, twin rat. Do you know what? Why not? Let's see what he got. If it's plus armor, I'd laugh. It's nothing. Maybe I'd take him on the LOS. I don't know. He can stay on the team. He can stay on the team and see if we make the playoffs. So, okay, so I've got Blodge Mighty Blow. So I took Dodge on a double earlier. He's finally leveled. And we get access to Claw. So we now have Claw Mighty Blow. On a Blodger as well. So I'm pretty happy about that. Team's actually looking pretty good. My block thrower's out, which is unfortunate. But I have the other thrower. He is in. I will fire Twin Rat and I have the bank to replace him. So that's something I can do at a later date. So 1060 TV. So 1110 TV is my real value. Which is quite good. Pretty much a full roster apart from the thrower. Nothing I can do about that. So that's pretty good all round. Claw for the meme's sake. I don't know, mate. I mean, he's out for the next game, so that's it for the season, isn't it? So he'd only come back for the playoffs. Like I said, I'm not going to fire him. I'll keep him. Yeah, he can sit on the bench with a magic sponge, feeling sorry for himself while thing. But I think I'd rather fire him and have a fresh rat in for my next game, because that is likely to be a little on the tough side. It's Nurgle. So it's a strength team again, and they've got foul appearance. So the leaderboard as it stands, I've taken second place. I'm on 3-2-1. So it's 11 points. That was a big win for me. I needed that. I'm really happy about that. I'm not safe though. Not safe by any stretch of the imagination. So the fourth place team. My last match, Scumdog Legionnaires, Black Swan's the coach. I would definitely, I mean, a win would obviously seal it for me, but a draw would be probably just as good at this stage, because then I'd be on 3-3-1. He'd be on 2-4-1. We'll see. Yeah, mate. Well, that's what this team's been, mate. It's just been a laugh, because I never played Underworld before, and I'm just trying. I mean, game one, my troll eats a goblin. So that was the start of my season. That was where the bar was set for me. And it's fluctuated in and around there. So I'm happy with that. Right, I'm gonna hang on. So just to have a look at the other team and the kind of damage that I did. So AV busted Saurus that had just leveled from the match before. Strength busted Skink. This guy is niggled. I remember that happening. And I did kill a Saurus as well, but he appoed him. Which is that guy there. So that was the appo. So yeah, so I gave as good as I got in that game. Right, I'm going to leave that there. Thanks for everyone that tuned in to watch. That was actually quite a lot of fun. It was a bit tense at times, but that made for a better game. So appreciate you watching. Appreciate anybody making a comment in chat. Wish me luck in the next round and see if I can make the playoffs. Again, like I say, thanks very much, guys. I'm going to leave it there. And I'm going to get off and put the kettle on. Thanks again.